On the road in Middle America, a leading candidate for the U.S. presidency. But all of a sudden, here it comes, the C word, Canadian.
Donald Trump is suggesting, saying that you had a Canadian passport.
It's not true.
False.
Yeah.
Never had a Canadian passport.
No, of course not.
From the mouth of Ted Cruz, no way, no how, no Canadian passport ever. What a relief. For those not up to speed on the true north bona fides of the man once derided as Canadian Ted, now vying for that most American of jobs. Calgary, 1970, key for Cruz and, for the moment, the 2016 presidency. See his birth certificate? Yep, born in Calgary and was thus a Canadian citizen right up until renouncing it in 2014. But born to a Cuban dad and American mom in Alberta meant Cruz was also a natural-born U.S. citizen, and that, say experts, along with a life mostly in the U.S., qualifies Cruz for the White House. Case closed. Enter this week, yet again.
He was born in Canada.
Fellow presidential candidate Donald Trump.
The problem is that if the Democrats bring a lawsuit, the lawsuit could take years to resolve.
Yes, the same Trump who not long back took a similar tack on someone else.
Barack Obama should give his birth certificate.
And now John McCain, former presidential candidate, himself born in Panama, who once deemed Cruz a wacko, seems among those siding with Trump.
I think there is a question. I am not a constitutional scholar on that, but I think it's worth looking into.
I think absolutely, without question, he is qualified and eligible to be the Prime Minister of Canada.
Cruz's comeback? Tweeting the old Fonzie jumps the shark video, code for pointless gimmick to boost ratings.
The Constitution and laws of the United States are straightforward. At the end of the day, this is a non-issue.
All of it, if nothing else, underlining Cruz is now deemed by many as a threat to win, thus worthy of attack, even for the crime of once being merely one of us. Paul Hunter, CBC News, Washington.